give a warm welcome Lionel Richie.
Good to see you again. Again we'll do this.
Welcome.
We made it.
Welcome to Scandinavia.
Thank you very much. It's lovely springtime weather you're having here.
Oh, yes, it is, isn't it?
Lovely California weather.
Lionel Richie, you have written some of the most romantic songs in pop history, which could make one imagine that you must have an exceptional love life.
Yes. And what's your question?
Could you confirm?
I can confirm that I have two divorces and four, I should say five now, two grandkids, fabulous children, and I'm actually friends with both of my ex-wives.
That's good.
My love life is terrible. but my in-love life is fabulous.
So being friends with your exes.
Yes.
How much did that cost?
Millions. Millions. No, you know what it is. You know what it is. I've come to the conclusion now that there's a moment in time when you're young, you're going to make mistakes. And it's just natural progression of life. To go back and say, I apologize for what happened in my early 70s or my early, there's no need to apologize because it was going to happen. Now let's compound the problem by putting rock and roll on top of that. Let's give you the music business, which is a disaster all by itself. And you are going to make mistakes. And so, you know, as I tell both of my ex-wives, I am never going to be that dangerous again ever in my life. I'll never be that dangerous again. I'm calm now. I'm a calm guy.
Are you, we were talking about the emotions. Are you an emotional guy?
Very much so. Very much so. In fact, I love this. What I was suffering from as a young kid. See, this is before we knew what ADD was and AADD and you name it. Okay. They said I was, Lionel is too sensitive. And they use the word hyperactive. Hmm. Now, that means I would make a terrible lawyer, but a great musician. You know what I'm saying? In other words, back then, there's only one road you would take. You were either normal, or something was wrong with you. And they told you that something was wrong with you. And they told your parents, you know, Lionel's not, he cries on a dime. He's too sensitive. People can hurt his feelings too easily. And I kept thinking, that's terrible. So I tried to be as tough and as rough as I could. I failed. But now, as time goes on, I realize that was the blessing. So.
And are you still as vulnerable?
Well, after two divorces, no. But, but yes. I mean, my kids have a joke. They say, okay, Dad, please, for God's sakes, don't start crying. Because, you know, I see them walk in the room. And, you know, I just get emotional because I'm so proud of them, you know. Or you see the grandkids walk in the room and you know, there's just, you know, regardless of all the songs, you know, when you see people you love walk into the room, that's, I'm Italian, I think, in some way. I've got too much Italian blood. I cry on everything.
That's a bit nasty.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But you are a true survivor in this business. I mean, you've been along for a very long time and it's quite amazing.
You know what's happened? This has just come up now. You're using a word now that I have not heard in my entire career. Survivor. You know, when we're all together, when we first start out, the Commodores and Michael Jackson and Whitney and everyone, Luther Vandross, and it's all a club. And you never think that we're not going to be anything but here. I've known Michael since he was 8 years old. I've known his brothers. We used to hang out. We, you know, And all of a sudden someone says, he died. And it's like impossible. Whitney dying. You know, you don't remember the end, you remember the beginning. Of all the hopes and the dreams of what we were sitting there talking about. And then when someone says, it's over. So they've been using this word, Lionel, you've been a survivor, which means I'm still here. And it's kind of spooky now because you think of all the people who have come and gone in our business. And it doesn't play like a wonderful love story. It plays like a tragedy, like a dramatic tragedy. And I'm finding myself now feeling sad about the business more so than excited about the business. Because the fame, the power, and the fortune.
It's too much for some.
Well, you know, I always tell people, money, power, and fame does not change you. It only magnifies you. So if you have a little problem, you've now got a big problem. Mm. But the way the technology is now, the whole world can see your problem, whereas before, you could keep it a secret for as long as you possibly could. But now they have investigative reporting now. You know that in the political business. I wouldn't want that in my whole country. But, you know, I mean, it's very difficult, you know.
But let me ask you something. How do you deal with your... Because I'm world famous in Sweden.
Right.
You're world famous in the world.
Yeah.
And that's lovely. That's wonderful. It's a lot of good things coming with that. But the meeting with other people, they always know that you're Lionel Richie.
I know. The first couple of years, it was too much. Mm-hmm. I did the Oscars, and I became Lionel Richie all night long. My name had extended. Lionel Richie all night long. Lionel Richie all night long. Hello, 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 hello. You know, and then you didn't think that would be a problem until you want to go and take your kid to her piano recital. Mm-hmm. I'm now taking Nicole to her piano recital. They didn't pay attention to her piano recital because the people are now taking pictures of me, so she couldn't relax. Now you want to be a dad, and they only see famous.
So when you want to relax, you go for places where there is nobody who knows what Lionel Richie is.
I go home.
Lionel, tell me about Nicole, because you mentioned her, and she didn't. I mean, her dad is a survivor, as I said, but she.